A humble teenager is tonight coming to the realisation that his quick actions saved the life of a stranger struck by lightning. Brett Clappert joins us live from the Royal Adelaide Hospital where the victim's being treated.
Rebecca, 17-year-old Jackson Marsh is in a critical but stable condition. He's now in an induced coma and has a fighting chance. But without the help of a young footballer from a rival private school, he may not have survived at all. A young life in the balance, but only thanks to a stranger. For Sam Andrew Arthur, instinct kicked in.
I did know what to do, but it was pretty full on and, like, yeah, probably the worst moment of my life.
The worst 5 minutes, to be exact. That's how long Sam administered CPR on Jackson Marsh while waiting for paramedics. The Pulteney Grammar student seen here comforted for his efforts. It's only by chance he was still at Kensington Oval.
We were about to walk into the car when the lightning went, so a couple more seconds and I probably wouldn't have been there.
Sam only recently completed his first aid course at school.
Sam, people are calling you a hero.
Nah, I'm not here. I just want him to get better and I just did what I could. Anyone would have done the same thing if they knew what to do. Until I can hear his voice for the first time, I don't feel anything.
Sam hopes to meet with Jackson once the condition of the Pembroke footballer improves. Doctors at the hospital where he's being treated say the reaction of Sam and Jackson's friends was life-saving.
The response was tremendous, really, and everybody who involved in that process did a great job.
The Pembroke school community expressing gratitude.
Jackson's been given a real chance as a consequence of the action of these young people.
Jackson's parents rushed back from an interstate holiday to his bedside, his mother telling 10 News she was too distraught to speak publicly. His friends had remained at his bedside until they arrived late last night. Sam Andrew Arthur has become their new friend, and he has a simple message for all people his age.
Having someone there that knew first aid could make a difference. So if everyone learnt first aid, it would, you know, it could help save lots of people.
That message has certainly been echoed by doctors here at the Royal Adelaide Hospital.
The boy Sam saved faces a long battle, yet the impact of a lightning strike as devastating as it is sudden.
Jackson Marsh was brought back to life at the scene where he was struck, but doctors say that's just the start of his road to recovery.
And it's a massive, large shock, electrical shock, and we're talking about millions of volts coming to the ground. And it's also, although it's very short-lived, there's a very high temperature in the flash.
Lightning strike injuries are often internal, making it difficult to evaluate a patient's condition. The 17-year-old Pembroke student is now critical but stable. His parents at his bedside. The family is well connected across football and cricket circles. The concern spreading across the border to Essendon player Angus Monfries, whose younger brother is Jackson's close friend.
My brothers, all of their sort of school friends are pretty sad at the moment, and mum and dad are good friends with their parents as well, so hopefully they can, show the support and hopefully can get through it.
The boys who were at the Oval at the time spent much of the night at the hospital, the school providing counselling.
Staggered by what's occurred, as you can imagine, with an event like this, so there is some trauma, but equally they're feeling really, positive for Jackson, that Jackson can pull through.
The Oval itself bears no scar from the strike. Stunned regular users extending their thoughts to Jackson's family as well.
This is a really well-used Oval. A lot of people with dogs and families and stuff like that. So for something to happen as serious as that, it is pretty shocking, pretty unfortunate.
And incredibly unlucky.
For an average lifetime of 80 years, you have a chance of about 1 in 6,500 of being hit by lightning.
Gia Laux, 10 News.